Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another video of me taking down my box braids. So in this video, I'm going to be taking down my box braids of 2 months, and I actually wasn't going to take down my braids yet. But you guys, on the left side where my hair is bleached and dyed, the hair that is poking out, it started to mat up and lock. Like my hair started to form locks. Okay, while on my side that my hair is black, the hair that is poking through is not locked up at all. Well, I don't know what was happening on the side that my hair was bleached, but I wasn't liking it, so I decided to take down my braids. Now, normally when I keep in my braids for a little longer than usual, I do tend to redo my braids in the front. Like I undo them, I unbraid them, and I braid them again just to make sure that my braids stay looking new. But to be honest, I was lazy, so that's why my edges look crazy, and that's why my edges started to lock up. And as you guys can see, I started to remove them, and some of the braids, like my hair would undo itself normally, just me like separating the hair with my fingers, but then some of it I needed help with something, like it wasn't separating at all and I didn't know what to do. But in one of the comments that you guys left in my other video of me taking down my braids, someone said that I should use conditioner. So I went to go get conditioner to see if it worked, but maybe I used it wrong. I tried placing conditioner in the demarcation line where my new growth and the hair that was braided joined. I don't know. But honestly, it did not work. So then my mom came in and she said, here, have this brush. This is the brush I always use on your hair to detangle it after your hair is out of box braids. And I never paid attention to this brush. But my mom is right. The second I placed it on my hair after undoing the braids, it literally just untangled the hair. I don't know where this brush was made, where it's from, but this is literally what saved my hair. So as you guys can see, after unbraiding each box braid, I just used this braid and I just used this brush on my hair, and it just started to like take out all of the garbage or whatever. And it looks crazy, I know, but your hair does shed like 100 pieces of hair per day. I don't know, but yeah. So that's what I use to untangle my hair. So you guys are just gonna see me undo my hair. And I did ask my sisters to help me as usual. And yeah. As I explained, normally the edges are the parts of the hair when you leave box braids in for really long that literally behave the worst. So it became really hard to detangle the edges especially, but I just left them for my mom to do it. And the rest, I let my sisters undo the hair for me. And since my scalp became very tender, I had to leave my hair alone for a day. And then I went to wash my hair the next day. So one thing that I didn't share with you guys, during these 2 months that I wanted to make three, but whatever, it became two, I did not wash my hair. So if you guys like follow my channel and stuff, you guys know that I always wash my box braids, but I did not wash my hair for 2 months. Why did I do that? Because I also bleached my hair a while ago, and I knew that bleaching my hair, my new growth, when it would come in, obviously it would come in black. So I wanted to measure the difference of how much my hair grows when I do nothing to it compared to when I do something to it, if that makes sense. So basically, I didn't put any oil on it. I didn't wash it at all. I didn't give it any tender love or care during these 2 months. And I let it grow by itself. And Now that I got my braids out, I'm going to start oiling my scalp again. I'm going to start taking care of my hair again, and I'm going to see if I'm going to have the same rate of growth that I had during the last 2 months. Now, I'm obviously just wetting my hair because now we're going to wash it and condition it. And before that, I was just showing you guys the products that I'm going to use in this video. So because my hair is very, very matted, today I'll have to divide it in 4 sections. So I'm going to divide it in 2 sections in the front and 2 sections in the back. I'm going to wash each section. And right after I finish washing the section with shampoo, I'm going to condition it. And right after I condition it, I'm going to detangle it using a lot of conditioner to make sure my hair is completely detangled. You guys can't really see it now, I'll show you guys later in the video, but my hair is really matted. Like, it literally is lifeless. It has no life. So I have to make sure I detangle it properly so that I can eliminate this type of dryness that my hair seems to have at the moment. As you guys can see, I'm using 2 different conditioners. There's nothing special about one or the other. I literally just need it to detangle my hair. So in that one section that I have in the back, I'm going to divide it 3 more times and place so much conditioner to the point that, like, I don't know, it's dripping or something. And then I'm going to take my brush and I'm going to detangle those 3 sections from that one section in the back of my hair, because using this brush really helps detangle my hair. If you guys watch my old wash hair routine, you guys will know that I used to detangle my hair with my fingers, like one by one. I think it's called singling or something. But ever since I found like brushes that help detangle my hair, I use it sometimes too. And I don't use it in every single wash day, but because, as you guys can see, my hair, like, it became locked and matted, I really needed to detangle it to make sure that I didn't get any knots. The secret really to detangling your hair like this is just to make sure that your hair is very wet, it has a bunch of conditioner, and start from the bottom of your hair and then work your way up. Because once you've detangled the whole section of your head, you realize that the brush goes through like butter. So I was supposed to repeat the whole process to the rest of my hair, which I am, but I accidentally placed conditioner on this section before placing shampoo. And I remember to show you guys just the texture of my hair. As you guys can see, it's very like lifeless. So that is the reason I am doing this whole routine of washing each section by section and then placing conditioner and then detangling it with a brush, because my hair really needs it because it's literally dying. So as you guys can see, it's a long ass process, but it's necessary. I even got shampoo in my eye, and throughout the video I was dying because I think my eye was just like suffering. I'm literally one of the lazy natural hair channels because like this whole dividing my hair in four sections thing, as I said, I don't do it often. I do it like once a month. Of course I should be doing it more often, but so after I finish washing and detangling my hair today, I'm only going to be using products that I bought. I usually like using natural products, or I mix it with the products that I buy, but today I'm only going to be using products that I bought for no particular reason. I just felt like it. But for the mask that I'm using on my hair, it has coffee in it, and coffee is really good for hair growth. I think it stimulates your scalp or something. And this mask is very, very heavy, and I don't know how people feel about very heavy hair masks on their hair, but I personally like it. I don't know, maybe it's just me, but I feel like it really like moisturizes your hair or something. So after I get the mask all over my hair, I'm going to take a wide tooth comb and I'm going to brush, comb my hair with the wide tooth comb. I don't need the brush anymore because I already used it to detangle my hair when I had the conditioner in. And before I wash it out, I'm just going to give myself a nice massage, because when you're washing your hair, it's good to massage your scalp because it helps with blood flow, which stimulates hair growth. So once I finish with the whole detangling process and washing my hair, I'm going to take some castor oil and I'm going to place it on the palm of my hand and then place it on my fingers and start massaging my scalp. After oiling my scalp, I'm going to take some hair cream, place it on my hair, and then although castor oil is a little heavy and I recommend a lighter oil, because I have castor oil, I just decided to use it to seal. And as you guys can see, I'm just going to twist my hair and then braid it, because to me, this is the fastest and easiest way to stretch out my hair. So yeah, this is basically my wash day routine after removing my 2-month-old box braids. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you guys in my next one.